So now for something completely academic. I love the fact that the word academic has two meanings. The other meaning, of course, is completely useless. So here's a big question. How do we have culture? Not why, that's a question I'd leave to Julian Baggini, but how? What are the processes and mechanisms by which we went from social animals to cultural animals? Now, chimpanzee have culture, they have traditions. So different troops of chimpanzee will do things differently. So one group will crack nuts in a different way to another group of chimpanzee. Now, we're trying to model that process of going from social to cultural with a group of robots right here now in Bristol. This is the Artificial Culture Lab. And these are the robots. The robots are called EPUCs. They have a simple eye, which is the camera. They have wheels to move, and they have a red skirt. The reason for the red skirt is that they don't see too well, so the red skirt helps them to see each other. Now, the project is based on the mimetic theory of cultural evolution. This is an idea based or originated by Richard Dawkins. The idea that culture evolves in the same way as biology, except it's memes. Now, a meme is a unit of cultural transmission. In fact, social learning is the way that we transmit memes. And in this project, we're particularly concerned with the imitation of movement. But, I hear you say, robots are nothing like animals or humans. But in fact, there are two important similarities. Robots have bodies, just like animals, and they have to learn socially in exactly the same way. Let me show you how. Here is a teacher robot, a robot basically doing a square dance. It takes four straight line movements and four corner movements to make a square dance. While it's doing that, a learner robot is watching. The learner robot sees the red blob, the red skirt, sometimes gets smaller, sometimes larger, sometimes move left, sometimes right. And the learner robot has to figure out what that movement sequence is. Now, human beings are very good at this, but in fact, the processing, the actual stuff that goes on in your head when you're trying to work out how to move your body to copy, for instance, a dance, is really, really complicated. Now, here are the robots actually doing their stuff. I'd love to show you a movie, but I can't because it's in the rules. So the robot on the left is doing its square dance. The robot on the bottom right is watching while it's doing that. And then they switch roles. So this time, the robot on the bottom right has done the square dance also. But actually, it's changed a bit. It's got it wrong. This time, the robot on the top left is taking the role of the learner. Now, if you do this, if you simply copy the last thing that you see over and over and over again, what we see here is a map of those two robots. And very quickly, the square dance degenerates. It goes to complete nonsense. Now, this is surprising, isn't it? Robots, we think, are perfect, but they're not. In fact, the robots get it wrong for exactly the same reasons that humans and animals get it wrong when they're copying. Now, copying the last thing you see is obviously not a good strategy. So let's try a different strategy. And here the strategy is that we remember every dance that we see, but in fact we then throw a dice. We choose at random the next dance that we're going to actually make. Here, robot B has got two dances in its memory, and it chooses one of them at random. Now, what's very interesting about this extremely simple selection strategy is that if you have a sequence of events, here's an example. So here, robot B copies A. This time it's a triangle dance, but it copies it badly, gets it wrong. We have this strange kind of figure of eight. But robot A copies that dance very well. Now, what we see here is that we have the emergence of a new kind of dance craze in the robots. So this figure of eight dance has taken over. It's become dominant, at least for a while. It's a kind of robot fashion dance. But how do we make sense of this if we have a lot of robots doing a lot of different dances? Well, we're right now developing a lot of different tools to try and understand this. This is what we call a memogram. So what have we learned about robot culture so far? Well, we've certainly demonstrated we think for the first time anywhere, the emergence of unique, new, emergent robot traditions. And the reason that we think we get this is because we have embodied robots that get it wrong when they imitate. Thank you very much indeed.